light welterweight contest between Peter Nightingale from Wensbury in the West Midlands, and he's facing Daniel James from Newmarket in Suffolk. Here comes Peter Nightingale. And the one big name on Nightingale's record was against Georgie Smith, the reigning Southern Area champion. James, on the other hand, well, he's not a bad little prospect unbeaten so far. But ranked one place behind Nightingale in the Independent World Boxing Rankings British type, British rating system. Comes Danny James from Newmarket, trained in the Peacock Gym, as you can see by the brace of Bowers in the corner. Newmarket, not Newcastle. Four fights, four wins. So, referee for this one, Ken Curtis. And timekeeper now, Ray Rice. Now, this is a 16-minute round match. And I'll just correct that. Daniel James from Newmarket, not Newcastle, as mistakenly said by Simon Goodall. Easy one to make. So round one. And as you can see already, Daniel James giving an inch or two here to Nightingale. And also Peter Nightingale's got long arms, so he could make life a bit tricky. For James. You don't get many fighters out of Suffolk these days. David Starr, in fact, was the recent British super middleweight champion. Lost that, of course, to Dean Francis in his last fight. And that, I think, is about the only representation we have Suffolk way. That's a fair left hook from Daniel James, but he's not getting all things his own way here. Interesting there. James got caught with the left hook as he went in. Well, pretty close first round there. Maybe Daniel James has just taken that one by the slightest of edges. Touch of replay then from round one. And that's in fact Daniel James leading him the left hook, but getting caught by the same punch at the same time. Round two then. So, Peter Nightingale in the striped trunks against the unbeaten Daniel James from Newmarket. And not much in the first round, I think you'll probably agree. James may have got the edge. Once again, that stiff jab from Nightingale, just catching James as he went to make his own move. That's lovely left hook work by James there. A good uppercut to start that combination and two left hooks. Lovely body shot from James there. That one made Nightingale just sink his knees a wee bit. And there's blood coming from James's nose. Oh, good left hook again from Nightingale. And those nice, clean, well-pressed white shorts now. With blood. But that's a good round, I think, for Daniel James, punching with authority. I think here, and at the moment Daniel James in the red corner, this man has won the pair of them, I think. And there is Jackie and Martin Bowers. I think it's Martin anyway, hope I'm right. So into round three then of this 6 2-minute round light waterweight contest. Still bags of fight left in this one. Quite a nasty nosebleed though for James. And as I say so many times, that is the least you can expect in this game. Of course, it's a mortal sin in amateur boxing. Still a competitive fight, this one. And both men want this nice left hook, right uppercut from Nightingale that time. And there's a cut now on Peter Nightingale's right eye, right at the end of the eyebrow. Now that might well have been a clash of heads. It could well have been a left hook though from James. Well, fortunately for Nightingale, the blood is coursing down the side of his face and not into the eye. Well, this has been a good round so far, I think, for Peter Nightingale. Well, yes, a very interesting round there. I think Nightingale's won that one by about as much as James won the first. Touch of replay then from round three. Bang, left hook there. In fact, left hook's a piece, but Nightingale's was better. So here we go then for round four. This is the halfway point of this six-round light welterweight match, and it's been a good one so far. In fact, I've got Daniel James winning the first two, and Nightingale winning round three there. Nightingale, remember, cut on the right eyebrow right at the very end. And James bleeding from the nose. Nice right from James. And let me remind you that boxing is very subjective. And so many people can watch the same fight and come up with an entirely different score. So I do forgive Ken Curtis if he doesn't see it the same way as I do. That's nice work from James. Once again, though, you've got Peter Nightingale responding, although not with quite the same kind of success. Well, no repeat then of that lovely knockout of Vince Burns that James scored. Oh, good stiff left hand there from James. It's been a bit of a war, this one, you know, at times. Well, good round then for James, just to stem the flow from Nightingale. Did well there. Right, penultimate round coming up then, and it's been a good match, this one so far. I've got Daniel James, in fact, a point in front, but that's a point that could disappear if Peter Nightingale in the striped trunks wins his last couple. In fact, he's still capable of pulling out a draw here if he wins the final two rounds, in my opinion. There looks to be some damage between the eyes of Nightingale at this stage. It might be just a tiny nick. And once again, you can see there the blood flowing from the nose of Daniel James. And punches like that are, of course, to blame. Once again, Nightingale have a good spell there, but took a good left hook. There's not a great deal in this round. They both probably realise it's close. Well, good round there. Once again, very close, but I suppose Daniel James might just have earned that one, being the aggressor almost throughout. And there's our overhead camera. For the sixth and final round in this match, and well, it looks like Daniel James is going to get this one, but he's had to fight very, very hard for it. Nightingale giving him a good old row. Double left hook then from James, and that might just be enough to seal in this round now. Once again, he is still the aggressor, and I got the impression, by the way, when Nightingale had a bit of success, it was by virtue of the fact that he was actually going forward. Once again, a good exchange there between these two. This one could go on again. Well, Nightingale's not done for yet. 15 seconds to go here in the sixth and final round. Well, it's all over now. Where's he going? He's gone. Yes, he has. He's gone for Danny James, who wins his fifth straight fight. Good effort, though, from Peter Nightingale. And my scorecard reading 59.5, 57.5, 5 rounds to 1, which might not seem terribly fair on Nightingale, because every round was hotly contested. And in fact, Ken Curtis has got it closer, I wouldn't mind at all. Right, let's go for the official score.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 6 long rounds of boxing, the referee is still in boxing. Peter Nightingale, 58 points. Daniel James, 60 points. Your winner, new world champion, Daniel James.
Well, he didn't give a round against James and gave Nightingale a share of 2 of them, which is not too far away from, in fact, the way I saw it. Half a point difference, in fact. Yes, a very good effort there from Peter Nightingale, but Daniel James unbeaten now in 5 pro starts, and he'll be pleased about that one. That was a tough fight.